it's funny. I don't really know if many people actually think about it, but isn't it weird to be conscious? No one really knows how it arises. Most people would assume that it is a property of the brain, but I'm not so sure. I would find it a sad world we live in if the magnificent beings such as plants didn't also have some form of consciousness. And I suppose things too, like jellyfish, moving very much like what we would consider alive with no brain. Furthermore, we know some people actually perform actions like going to the fridge, eating while asleep. We seem to drift in and out of consciousness through our experience of dreams as the night moves in progression. What we do know about sleep, however, is that it is required by the brain as a form of maintenance. But it doesn't shut down at all. Our brains go through various stages during the night with varying levels of activity. What I think is happening is a processing of the day's information by means of your spirit or essence. We know that information can be carried through the air by particles. This is how the internet works. I think sleep is the time when our bodies go into a more potent form of information processing via an unknown force, what I'll call spirit. As a means of staying there, this force guides particles of favorable information to favorable neurons, more or less tries to discard particles of unfavorable information. This force is essentially your essence. And I think it's possible that our soul consciousness takes a rest, tunes out of the world for a brief moment, while many of our neurons stay active, like as if they possess their own consciousness, like a civilization within a civilization. I think perhaps that's how our brains work, and how we experience the phenomena of a calculating, remembering mind. No one really knows exactly how the brain stores memory. I suppose it's like every conscious soul has a limited amount of memory and calculative power. What makes a human special is that we are in constant subconscious communication with the civilization within us. We can both hold ideas and communicate them to its neighbors. The main and most important component of this theory is the spirit, and it's how one soul differentiates itself from any other. If we don't have some kind of continuum of characteristics or behavior, then no soul is any special, and we would just be manifestations of our environment. The theory, and there is some evidence to back this theory, is that we have a force within our bodies that unconsciously moves particles, molecules, and ultimately cells around in an intelligent manner, like as if what we experience consciously becomes downloaded to this force, which helps us adjust who we are. For example, if you were a vegetarian in one life, then in your next life, to retain who you were and are, you would feel a certain way about fruits and vegetables by means of varying levels of dopamine and other neurotransmitters that provide with us different ways we feel. Like for example, when you take certain drugs, you flood your brain with molecules that make you feel good, while the brain can produce these molecules on its own too. Evidence to the existence of spirit was discovered by Cyrus Levental. He noted that because of the very large number of degrees of freedom in an unfolded polypeptide chain, the molecule has an astronomical number of possible conformations, basically saying that the protein has so many potential mistakes it could make as it folds, that it would take too long to fold into its functioning form were it only by the known forces of electromagnetism, gravitation, and so on.